All right, so hey there, everyone. It's so exciting to be here, seeing us all united to talk about Angular in these 2 days. It's pretty special for our speakers. I mean, we have amazing organizers that decide to organize the conference, and then we get contacted, and next thing you know, we're smiling in front of 700 people. I find that pretty cool. So my name is Rodric, and I'm a developer on the core team, and I'm here to talk to you about Angular behind the scenes. So more specifically, what I want to talk about is what I believe makes Angular special. So this is a technical talk, so you can put your notepads to the side and just listen to me try to entertain you. So I got involved in Angular about 2 years ago, and if you asked me why I thought it was special back then, I'd probably say something related to directives, bindings, or dependency injections. You know, while those concepts are great and they do make the framework special, my answer to that question has changed over the course of the last year. Now it has to do more with the people behind the project, as well as how they use the Google infrastructure to benefit everyone. So I currently work for the team remotely from Montreal, Canada, but during last summer, I got recruited as an intern and spent 4 months working with the team in Mountain View, California. And with that experience, I often get asked, what are the kind of stuff you only find out once you join the team? Or how did you get your internship in the first place? And those are fun questions to answer, and I want to try to do so with some personal stories and observations. The one to start with naturally is how I got my internship, which actually happened last year in that corner of the room. Vojta was standing there enjoying his first day of ng-conf 2014, and I wanted to talk to him. I had some stuff I wanted to show him, but I wasn't sure, how do you approach someone whose full-time job is to build a superhero? So I'm usually a pretty resourceful guy, and I had these free drinks coupons, and I'm under 21, and you can't drink in the US if you're under 21. So I came up to Vojta and offered him my drinks. And he jokingly replied, asking me if he should go to the bar, get the drinks, and come back to give it to me. And I declined. I won't break the law. I'm Canadian after all. From there, we started talking. I showed him some stuff I was working on. He liked it. We were talking passionately. And then Mishko joined us, and he asked me, hey, would you like to join the Angular team as an intern? And my initial response to that was, yes, but I need to ask my parents first. But it was actually the good response, because a week later I got contacted by Google HR, I did my interviews, and then flew to California to become a Google intern on the Angular team. It was a new experience for me, and I got to learn a lot. I didn't spend my days making coffee, I actually worked on some cool projects. The proof of that is, this is on my first week, I broke the build. I had Igor as my supervisor, and I got to work on stuff like speeding up Angular, improving our Travis build, or helping out with the tracer compiler. And I got to interact with many members of the team, and I realized how much their work affect people around the globe, but they're still humble about it. This project's pretty big. We have almost 1,200 contributors on GitHub, but there's obviously a small set of people who work full or part-time on the project. And I tried to make a list of them. And when I look at this list, there's something special that pops in my mind. So in the last 2 years that I've been involved in this project, I've witnessed the first contributions of many of these people. I realized that many of them joined the team by their help and contribution on GitHub, not by some Googling hire process. They got noticed by their help, not by their resume. Now, it's my story too. Before becoming an intern, I was a regular, normal contributor on GitHub. I would help with issues and send pull requests. And I feel that strongly makes us a part of the community. As opposed to apart from the community, there's an obvious vocabulary error here, there's a missing white space. That's better. All our work happens on GitHub, public for anyone to see, not on some Google internal tool. And even our meeting notes and our design docs, they're all on Google Docs for anyone to see. We even tweet about those stuff, so you can come, read them, comment on them, and join the conversation. I've been in many critical discussions inside my internship that started in person for convenience, but quickly moved to GitHub for further community feedback, or also we take notes and put them on Google Docs for anyone to comment on. And I really like that about our team. Most of us come directly from the community, And it's one of the reasons why I believe Angular is special. You know, so if you see us walking by and you have something to tell us, don't hesitate to do so. I mean, that's how I got my internship. And also, it's a great way to create collaboration between people and organizations. And this doesn't just apply in person. I mean, if you want to, if you have something to tell us, you can reach to us online. And if there's space for collaboration, we'd be happy to chip in. Oh, and by the way, I'm still under 21, so and I still have these free drinks coupons. So if you want them, you now have a reason to come up to me and talk. All right, so far my presentation was filled with emotions and personal opinions, but this is a technology conference, so I'll try to be more technical for the next story. So we're still talking about what makes Angular special, and I want to go over our release process because I believe it's very telling. So we pop up a new Angular version every single week, and it's a great way to get quick community feedback. And also, if you send us a pull request, you'll be able to benefit from your change much quicker than if we release at a slower rate. So on the fifth week of my internship, I got asked to be the release master. Well, it wasn't much ask as much as it was, Roddy, you're doing the release, but I still hopped on the opportunity to do it. We have a specific set of tasks that we need to do to get out a new version, so it wasn't all that complicated. Now, the first thing you have to do as a release master is to make sure that our stable branch is as up-to-date as can be, without including any breaking changes. So we ask our contributors to send their pull request to our master branch, which is where we're developing 1.4 right now, but every time we merge something new, if it doesn't have any breaking changes, we'll cherry-pick it to 1.3, which is our stable branch. So if your app depends on the stable branch, you'll always get the best Angular we can give you without including any breaking changes. And if it depends on the latest branch, you'll always get the new goodies fast, but I suggest you continue reading our changelog every once in a while, just in case we introduce a feature with a breaking change, just to avoid undesired surprises. So as a release master, I had to make sure that this process had been done correctly, because there's a lot of activity that happens on the Angular repo. You know, there's an average of 30 to 40 commits that get reviewed and merged every single week, and we don't want our stable branch to miss out on any. So if there's a commit that's in the latest branch that isn't in the stable branch, there needs to be a reason for it. All right, so latest versus stable branch, that has been taken care of. Now next, there's testing. And I gotta say, in Angular, we're pretty wild on testing. And we have the thing where we have almost 4,000 unit tests that run every time we hit save on a new file. And you might think that's enough, right? But actually, our full test suite has a lot more. Now, you see the tests that sometimes show up in our documentation that go with some examples? You might think that those are just for readers to check out, get familiar with how tests are written in an Angular application. But actually, we take those examples with their tests and run them to make sure that they're working correctly. So not only do we run our unit tests to make sure that things work as we expect them, but we also run our documentation tests to make sure that what you're reading is valid. And also, you know the whole thing was jQuery versus jQuery? You know, jQuery is this lightweight version of jQuery that ships with Angular and only contains the stuff we need. And you probably know that when jQuery is available on the page, Angular will use it instead of jQuery. Well, we run our tests in both scenarios, with and without jQuery. Also, when we push to GitHub, Travis picks it up, and it runs our tests in all major browsers. That's Chrome, Firefox, Safari, 9, 10, and 11. Now, I did the calculation, and that's almost 50,000 tests run each in a different scenario or environment. And you'll probably think that's enough, right? But actually, there is more. So you know I said all our work happens on GitHub, but we have almost 2,000 Google apps that use Angular. So what we do is we sync our GitHub commits into Google's internal code base. And you can see the status of that on our dashboard. And once we do that update, we trigger the tests of all the Angular apps inside Google to make sure that we didn't break anything for them. So for example, there's the Google Cloud Platform, which is written in Angular. Whenever we update Angular, we run their tests. And it's a great way to see if they're to make sure that the use cases that 100 other developers thought of and that they're still valid without ever needing to consult us. So that means that we have our unit tests, end-to-end tests, and docs tests that we run in all major browsers with and without jQuery. And we also have the Angular apps inside Google that we run their tests before doing every release. So when the first time I found out about this, I was pretty mind blown. Like, I mean, so much tests, so much CPU power. But at least Google leans on renewable energy, so that's good. So tests, that was fun to talk about. Another thing that's fun to talk about is release names. So whenever we do a new Angular version, we give it a code name, which we, because Angular is a superpower, it needs to be a super, because Angular is a superhero, it needs to be a superpower. You know, and we started out great with code names like Dragon Breath, Cold Resistance, or Repulsion Field. But then I'm not sure what happened, and then we ended up with names like Eggplant Teleportation, you know, Prime Factorization, pretty good superpower, Bare Hand Atom Splitting, and Beer Underestimating. You know, great superpowers, I know. There's probably a story behind each one. So far we have 132 versions, so 132 superpowers. And you can actually come and submit your own on this URL. It's actually a Google moderator, so it's fairly easy to use. Just come, suggest your release name, vote on the stuff you like, and maybe you'll end up naming the rest release. See some people taking pictures. Okay. So when I was doing the release, I had to get out the latest and a stable version. I named my latest version Ephemeral Acceleration because it had a lot of performance boost, and my stable one, Ear Extendability, because it had a lot of documentation changes. You know, when I did the tasks, I published on NPM, Bower, and RCDN, and it was on a Friday night, you know, best time to do a release. nothing could go wrong, right? We've changed since then. So when I was doing the release, actually something did go wrong. So I hadn't verified if the tests inside Google were passing, and they actually weren't. But I'm actually kind of proud of that. I mean, on my first week, I broke Angular. On my fifth week, I broke Google. probably next step for me is breaking the internet. If you have any tips on how to do that, let me know. From there, I couldn't just leave the office and keep Google broken. So I did what anybody in my position would have done. So I took out my Angular cape from my back pocket, it was upside down, and I put it on. And then I turned back to my laptop to debug. I found out that it was actually a pretty simple issue. With one of the performance commits, we had shortened. My mic's still good. Okay. So with one of the performance commits, we had shortened one of our internal properties, and that was causing a naming collision with a library inside of Google. It was actually the expando property, which is a property jQuery and jQuery uses to put on HTML elements, and that's for tracking data across an application. So to fix it, all I did was append my favorite number to it, which is 339, and voila, I'd fixed the issue. And from there, I had to do release again. This time I named it idiosyncratic numerification, and it has just one fix in it. That's why you'll find it in the changelog. If I have some advice I could give you, is that if you're still on Angular 1.2, you should try to upgrade to 1.3, because you'll get performance boosts right out of the box, and also my favorite number will be on all your HTML elements. The same thing with 1.4 just around the corner. And when it gets stable enough, you should also consider upgrading, because you also get performance boosts there, and also my favorite number is still in it. So, all right. So to recap more on my Angular, why Angular is special. So even though our organization contains a lot of people that work for Google, most of us come directly from the community. And I'm a good example of that. And also, we try to keep everything public so anybody could contribute easily. We're an open source project after all, and the barrier for contribution should, and in my opinion, is minimal. And we also try to give you the best Angular we can by maintaining latest and stable versions, and also by having an amazing testing infrastructure, taking advantage of our position in Google. Now, these are the kind of stuff you don't find out on a project's homepage, but they still, in my opinion, make Angular a one-of-a-kind project. So thank you for listening, and thank you for your support. And if you have any questions about my internship experience or our release process, don't hesitate to do so after the conference, or after my talk, or on Reddit. So thank you.